Hi guys, welcome back to our channel.
My name's Ty.
My name's Kenny.
And we are the BaloTwins. So, we are now in the second round of the Don Jazzy Shorts Challenge.
Thank you guys for the love and the support so far. And thank you to Don Jazzy's team for choosing us.
Uncle Don has asked us to make a sample video of the type of videos that would like to be shown on our channel.
Now, here at BaloTwins, we don't do mediocre. So instead of one example video, we're making a mini compilation of all the series that we have already planned out but haven't had time to make, basically. We hope you guys enjoy what we hope to be doing in the future, and we hope this gets us to the finals.
So, put a lot of effort into this, and we hope that you enjoy it.
Let's go. Hollywood has managed to propel itself as one of the biggest film industries in the world in only 2 decades. But what led to the historic feats of Nigerian film go further back than that. So let's separate Nollywood's life into 4 distinct eras and see the racism, desperate hope, and thirst for relatability that spawned the Nigerian film industry, what we now know as Nollywood. Starting with... Britain was losing
influence. The way she said it. It's the way she said it. And the way she doesn't want people to
go against it,
state their opinions. There will always be people to go against you. You could say, let's not kill babies, and somebody will give you 10 reasons why they should. That's the world. That's the world that we live in. So I don't see why somebody would come on social media and then expect other people to not. Okay, this is what I like. What are you trying to say? She said that pictures of Nigerian history are cool. Then why are you arguing with everybody? If that's your main point,
is that cuteness?
Hi guys.
Hi.
Welcome back to our channel. Yeah. My name's Ty.
My name's Kenny.
And we are the BaloTwins. We have come again. New year, new us.
New wine. So, today,
new setup.
Yeah. We're going to do something a little different. We want to start a kind of like wine talk series.
We stole this idea.
We stole this idea from Damon Dominique. But we really enjoyed it and we thought,
why not?
Why not? We really feel like people our age will have something to relate with in like our thoughts and our ideas and stuff like that.
Ooh! Do you see that?
This is a
white man
that
entered
the white
woman. Why is he wearing such bright clothes? No. Black. He's not wearing pink, blue, white.
This place is everywhere else. Ginger hair. Dark green. I'm making him worry. And he's wearing bright yellow.
It's like yellow. It's like a bright yellow. Anyway, we move.
Okay, when it comes to black people, they'd be like,
oh, bright colors are best friends. Bright purple, bright green, bright yellow.
White boy wears it. You're talking about, oh, he's clashing with the environment. Climate
change.
Pretty good.
I'm losing. Yeah, that's what he's saying now.
You said I'm blue. Like, I'm Toby Lou.
I cannot do this.
This is like a Harajuku
guy. Stop losing.
Sorry. It was like, me but I'm on bully.
What the f***? How the f*** would I know?
I thought it was like body. I became fango, but I smoke body. Like, sorry, can we just pause? No, look at this girl.
This song is hella catchy though.
Look at this girl looking like Christina Aguilera. Does she not look like Christina Aguilera right here?
Yeah, 2008.
Exactly.
Yeah, please.
Sorry. I'm new. Whoa.
Let me enjoy it, bro. And all the,
no, you know,
all the things you